There you go. So yeah, welcome to Driftwood. And basically, you guys are... I've got all of your backgrounds, all your background stories and stuff, so you don't need to elaborate, but I think we should go around the group and so you can just give us a couple of lines about your character and stuff. So we'll go from left to right. And Sam, how would you... Is that Shireen Emery?
Shireen.
Shireen, yeah, okay. So tell me a bit about Shireen.
Okay. Well, she grew up in Rubion in the Three Kingdoms.
Mm-hmm.
And she doesn't really know who her real family is. She just grew up with this other one.
Mm-hmm.
And the father in that family was a descendant of the one of the founders of the Smith Institute,
mm-hmm.
banking. So, like, they were pretty well off. But they kind of treated her like shit. And well, because she was, like, really...
The actual Smith Institute. So he would be fucking loaded then.
Yeah.
Yeah, so, okay. So,
and so, yeah, she was, like, really interested in steam tech and, like, studying weapons and things,
mm-hmm.
and he didn't really like that, so she left and met up with these two guys named Max and Roland,
mm-hmm.
and they did, like, sharpshooting shows for, like, different small driftwood towns.
Mm-hmm.
So she started, like, maintaining their weapons and traveling with them. And one day they chased some bandits off of some merchants, and mm-hmm. that was where she found her wolf. He was, like, in with the bandits' loot and everything. So, yeah, mm-hmm. she has a wolf now.
Okay, and the wolf's name is?
Asher.
Okay, and how big was this wolf, would you say?
He was a puppy when she found him.
Mm-hmm.
Now he's about two, probably.
So he's, like...
So he's like
a big dog, basically, now.
Yeah, he's pretty big. He's probably not full grown yet,
mm-hmm.
but he's getting there.
Mm-hmm.
And he's adorable.
I have the stats for him right here, so that's good.
Oh, all right. Okay.
Is there anything else? Describe Shireen in three words. That's what we did last time, and I banked.
Oh,
us.
Let's see. Let me... I was not ready for that.
Yeah, just off the top of your head. It doesn't need to be in depth. Don't need to explain it, just off the top of your head. First three things that come to mind.
I don't know, she's definitely awkward.
Mm-hmm.
I see a pattern here.
Yeah.
What?
Nothing.
Don't make me kill you, Chen. Probably optimistic.
Uh-huh.
And compassionate.
Well, that wolf is a...
Look, my word that I was going to use.
No, you can use the same one. Alright. So, we'll go with Damien now. Who's Damien Lockhart and what's he been up to?
Alright. So, Damien Lockhart is me. So, Damien was born in a small, like, township.
Mm-hmm.
The name of the town was Brindale.
Yep.
He was born to his parents, Amelia and Aaron.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, no, those are the siblings.
Sorry.
No, his parents were Reginald and Diana.
Cool.
Reginald.
His siblings are Amelia and Aaron. Amelia is going to be his older sister, and Aaron is his younger brother.
Mm-hmm.
He was born in a, like, infected town, so he got his magical powers from
okay.
the, like, Shining area.
Sounds good.
When he was in the town, he was kind of in charge, or not, like, in charge, but he was one of the people who was sorting through crops and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And one day, a band of people came into town. They call them the Band of Brass. They came into town and, like, ransacked everything. They mm-hmm. stole a bunch of crops and stuff and got sick. So, they burned a lot of the town to the ground while Damien and Amelia were out searching for a new water source.
Mm-hmm. So you like narrowly escaped the raid then?
Yeah. After like a few years had passed since then, he was searching for his little brother, which was never found in the wreckage of the town.
Mm-hmm.
So he was trying to find the Band of Brass to kind of find out what happened to his brother, and also to seek revenge for his parents, who both mm-hmm. died when they attacked. During that period of time, his older sister Amelia got injured during his escapades, so he kind of decided to settle down. He's taking care of his sister now and trying to just do side work, basically, of like figuring like anything basically magical related that he can get money for. He's trying to get money through those means now instead of being kind of like a mercenary.
Okay, that's cool. So describe Damien and... Oh, and I've added that town to the map. That's about 25 km away from where you are now. So, yeah, it's okay. Within like a... you can literally get on a jeep or a buggy or something and get there in about a couple of hours, you know. So it's not like that far away. So, in three words, describe Damien for me.
I would say he's determined.
Mm-hmm.
Sarcastic.
Yep.
And caring.
Okay, we're a nice bunch of people. Okay, we'll see how long this lasts.
All right. Yeah, I don't like the sound of that.
Yeah, Jackson, tell me a bit about Jackson.
All right, so Jackson Steele was born on his family farm just outside of Tombstone.
Mm-hmm.
His mother died when he was about 4 or 5 years old, mm-hmm. Giving birth to his younger brother, whose name is Carnegie Andrew Steele.
Mm-hmm.
I so cannot take that seriously. Go on, sorry.
Take it seriously. So then they were just left to be raised by their father, whose name was Forrest Steele.
Mm-hmm.
And he basically taught them, you know, how to be self-sufficient and run the farm and how to shoot and everything. And when Jackson turned 19, his father died because of magical poisoning. Mm-hmm. And Jackson basically, you know, took care of his brother after that. Like, he was his caretaker. Taught him everything his father didn't have time to. After a while, Jackson got kind of fed up with the whole farm lifestyle and decided to sell it, and he wanted his brother to go to school. So he had his brother move to Sundance,
mm-hmm.
To go to college or whatever their system is there.
Mm-hmm.
And he bought some supplies and, you know, set off on his own to go do his own thing. He wound up in Ruvian and joined up with a airship called the Relentless.
Yep.
And it's part of a group called Heretics Lament.
Mm-hmm.
And they basically fly across trade routes and loot corporate trade vessels. And what else? Basically, whatever money he gets, he sends to his brother to keep having him, you know, continue his education and live and everything.
Yeah,
sounds fair. That's about the gist of him.
Describe him in three words.
I'd say compassionate. Precise and deadly.
Ooh. Okay. All right. So I thought I'd start by, just for posterity on YouTube and things, and for people watching on Twitch and RP. Hello, RP. This is the first one we've done for you South African guys for a while. 18 people there, so that's nice. So Driftwood is basically it's not a twist, but this isn't a twist, so don't worry about it, but it's actually a world in Minerva's Cradle. It's a very sequestered world, you know, in the back end of nowhere. Basically, no one's come across it yet. And no one's likely to either, because the Empire of Earth, when it was across the stars and all that, was it was in control of entire galaxies, and Driftwood is in another galaxy, but it was in the same empire as Minerva, as Minerva's Cradle. And this is the world that's left of probably one of the most advanced worlds in the Empire of Earth, which is basically space Romans, for want of a better word. And this is what's left of it after the Dead Riders came through and annihilated everything. So a lot of the history of Driftwood is actually confused, and it's very similar to, to the history of primitive cultures in Minerva's Cradle as well. So they don't really talk about the Empire of Earth, but they do talk about the Empire that was from Driftwood. They believed they were the center of the Empire when they really weren't. You know, it was Earth that was the center. But the Dead Riders are very much a thing on Driftwood, and the wall between the astral plane, which is where magic resides, and life here in real world, is very, very, very thin because of the sheer amount of death that happened in Driftwood. So Driftwood is bombed all over by neutron bombs and, you know, hydrogen bombs, and so magic is a very weird amalgamation of nuclear energy and corruption and magic from the astral plane, from another plane. And that magic normally comes from where the Dead Riders come from. That's what everyone thinks, anyway. So you guys are all traversing this world, and you've been living here from the very beginning, pretty much from when you were children. And Shireen and Jackson, you've actually been called to a place called Old Shackleton. It's called a village called Old Shackleton, and you've been called there by a man called Jared Blake, who is you know him by reputation. He's a low level handler of mercs and people like that. And Shireen, you know Jared through Roland Hall. They were actually friends and running partners for a while. And Jackson, you know Jared Blake by reputation, because you are he was the guy you replaced on that airship. Mm-hmm. When he came down to set up his business in this village, you actually replaced him on the airship. Damien, you don't know him, and so you're basically hanging out on the outside of the village. You've been told to wait for these two other mercs, and so you're just basically standing there with your arms folded, not really, you know, giving two shits about anyone. So I'm going to move you all across to the first map that we've got. Yeah, this is the town of when it comes in. But this is the town of Old Shackleton. So it's made on a small river that barely supports it, and the battle market in the centre is actually a tavern. It's actually a market and a tavern in one. So I'm gonna let you guys enter in of your own accord. You draw yourselves like a little cross or a arrow, whatever you want to draw, wherever you like. The town's busy-ish, you know, there's people milling around doing different jobs and odds and ends and stuff. It's perishingly hot, it's horribly hot. So you guys, your clothes are sticking to you, and you need to get out the sun, you know, so you need to get a drink. That's what most of you are thinking. So we'll do Shireen first. I want to draw you and your wolf. Where are you? Where? Hello.
Hello.
Hello?
Yeah. Can you draw yourself on the map for me?
Yeah, which direction are we coming from?
No, I mean, you can draw yourself anywhere. It doesn't matter.
Oh, just anywhere? Okay. Yeah. I will be...
You can be inside the town.
I'll be here in the shade.
Okay. Just underneath there, yeah. Okay.
Yeah, and then... Yeah.
You
go ahead.
Next to you, Shireen, there is an old woman, like, sitting on the floor with her hands upturned. And she has a sign on you know, in her lap, just saying water on it. She's just, like, holding her hands out to you, but, like, giving you a toothless grin. And her skin's all, like, weathered and, you know, dust-ridden.
Do I have any water?
Yeah, you have a few sachets of water.
Okay, I'll give her some water then.
Okay, have some XP for that. She thanks you and finally talks and says, "Are you looking to get anywhere? I've got information if you need it."
Yeah, I'm looking for a man called Jared Blake. Do you know anything about him?
Ah, the guy who runs the battle market. Yeah, he'll be in there. Just tell him Susie sent you and he'll set you up with a tab.
Okay. Thank you.
No worries. And she goes back, like, drinking her drink. So, Jackson, where are you?
I am... Oh my god, that is big. Boom. Right there, next to the guardhouse.
Alright, and Damien, where are you?
I'm going to be right over...
Okay.
Here.
Alright, so Damien, what are you doing in the town? Because you know you've got to meet these guys somewhere. So,
yeah.
What are you actually doing?
At the moment, I am just kind of leaning up against a building, waiting for people to come by that look like they're mercenaries.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, mercenaries in this town do stand out. Whilst none of you are armed, because you were requested to come to the meeting without any equipment, you do have, like, you know, like trench coats on, and it's a trench coat is the general mark of a mercenary in the Driftwood. All the black coats have your ex-slaves, you know, they all have trench coats, you know, most of the merc band have trench coats. And you guys are all, like, wearing this, like, light leather trench coats at the moment. So people are, like, giving you a sideways glance there, Damien, thinking, yeah. Like, weighing you up as you go past, because, you know, mercs are looked upon with a bit of suspicion and respect as well. You know, they're quite respected. So, Jackson, what are you going to do? I take it, Shireen, you're going into the bar now.
Yeah.
Okay.
Where... may or may not be blind. I can't see where it is.
It's the battle market in the middle. It's the big thing in the middle.
Oh, it's that. Okay.
Yeah. Did I have a map for that? Not that I need one, but I just thought... No.
Yeah. And that little black thing is my dog.
Okie doke. So yeah, Jackson, what's going on?
I'm going to walk around until I can... see something.
Okay.
Or, like, just ask around and see if anyone knows who this Blake fellow is.
Alright, an old man stumbles past you and he goes to fall. Like, he literally trips. Looks like he's gonna fall right in front of you. What are you gonna do?
I'm gonna use my super fast reflexes and catch him before he falls.
Okay, go for it. The D100 on your speed, I think.
Oh boy, here we go. Let me see.
I don't think we have speed in Driftwood.
Oh, right. What is it?
Yeah.
We have.
Got body, flash, blade,
says
word.
Says the man who wrote the rules. You know.
Dead perception. Eye, intelligence, perception.
Yeah, do perception, because that'll be your. Yeah. Snapping guy.
Alright, so how would I.
Roll? Just roll D100.
Forward slash D100.
Yeah, forward slash roll D100.
Oh, right. I missed that there.
Nope.
Forward slash space roll? No, forward slash roll space D100. Oh. There you go. That's a fail. So he, like, face palms into the dirt and right in front of you, and you're like, huh. And you just, like, step over him and continue walking in this general direction down here. And he's, like, in the fog going, "You asshole!" As you go past, like, just like flipping you off in the dust, and you just, like, shrug and carry on walking. And you see what purports to be a merc standing over here. So you actually, like, lock eyes with Damien, and Damien just, like, sort of locks eyes with you. And it's one of those, like, you know, in the movies where like, it zooms in to their eyes and they just, like, squint a little bit at the sight of each other. And, yeah, so what do you want to do?
I'm going to ask him, are you looking for Jared Blake as well?
I don't know. I was told to meet two mercs around this town.
All right, well, I'm a merc, so I'm assuming you're meeting me. So I'm just walking around aimlessly looking for this guy. So if you want to walk with me as well, we can walk together.
Sounds like a plan. At least I found one of them.
Do you try to hold his hand? Or
no hand hold. Not yet. We don't know each other that well yet.
I just thought I'd clarify. All right. So you guys can see like the guardhouse down here. And they've got like militia men and shit like that. But you also see like a big entrance here to the bar. And
my character is split into multiple pieces.
Yeah, it happens to me. That's why I generally don't draw on them. But you guys have to.
Okay, hold on. I need
delete him and then make him again. Normally it's better to do it in like an arrow shape.
Or do it in a single stroke.
Yeah, or you can just do it in like a single stroke here.
Okay, Dean, really quick.
Uh-huh.
So, with my stats, my perception is a 7, but I'm rolling a D100, and I'm assuming I'm multiplying the 7 by 10.
Yes, you need to basically get a 70 or below to succeed, but in Driftwood, a 91 could have been a pass if you were if there was extenuating circumstances. So, say, like as it says in the rules, if you're trying to fool somebody into thinking you're a guard, and you need to roll in your flash, you know, to convince them. Well, that if your flash is 4, you'd need a 40 or below, which is quite a low chance, you know. But if you roll then a 61, but you're wearing a guard uniform, and you role play the act of a guard quite well, I'll say that's a pass. Do you know what I mean? So it's more leeway there.
Yeah.
It's not like a be all end all. So you guys see the front of this bar over here? So, and you've all got $50 each, by the way. That's just your starting money. You've got, like, enough for a drink and stuff.
Sorry, taking notes.
And, Shireen, you walk into the bar on the opposite side, and you can see, like, two mercs stroll into the bar on the opposite side to you. The rest of the bar, like, the atmosphere changes because everybody sitting around sort of goes, oh shit, like there's like three mercs have just walked in and eyeing each other suspiciously. So your wolf immediately starts to like a low growl in the back of its throat that only you can hear. No one else can hear it, but it starts like pacing and looking at the two people who've just come in.
Head him and let him know that, you know, everything's okay.
Okay. Cool. The guy behind the bar is like wiping the bar, and he just eyes the wolf with like a suspicious look, and he goes, "Are you Shireen?"
Yes.
All right. He goes, "All right, I got whiskey and one shit tequila. Which one do you want?"
I'll take whiskey.
All right. So he pours you whiskey into like a tumbler and just like slides down the bar to you. And do you want to
body check?
No, do a check on your highest stat, whatever your highest stat is.
That would be my intelligence.
Okay, so you can intelligently pick up the thumbler.
It's 10, so.
Yeah, go for it.
I'll have to roll a pretty...
A
really good roll.
You,
when I don't need it.
No, it's a D100, not, fucking hell.
That is a D100.
Wow. Alright, so you, the drink is like slid down the bar and you just like flick it up with your hand and then just like, as the whiskey drops out of the glass, you just open your mouth, it goes into your mouth, and then you pluck the thimble out of midair and just flick it back to him, and he just catches it and goes, huh, and just sits it back down again, but he's quite impressed by your skills there. So, the other two mercs, he's noticed you guys, And he says, hey, you two over there, gawking. Yeah, yeah, you two. Tequila or whiskey?
How much is each?
On the house.
I'll take tequila.
Okay.
I'll take a whiskey.
All right, so he pours you both whiskey and slides down the bar. You can do your checks if you wish, to see if you can... Nothing riding on it, really.
You said on our highest stat?
Yep.
All right.
Yeah, they mean just downs his without... Yeah, you both down your drinks without any special event. You just, like, down them and then send them back. And he just nods and he goes, take a seat at the bar. And he says... And he looks at the other guys around the bar. And you, using your mercenary perceptions, you can all see that they're all armed underneath their jackets. He tells them all to take a hike. And they go and sit on other tables to let you sit at the bar. Okay. This bar's actually Drifter's Retreat. So, and a few of you have been here before. You know, you've all... been through town, and a few of you have seen Blake. And as I said before, he's an ex-member of the Relentless Airship crew, and he knows Roland Hall. He's good friends with him. And he basically pours you all a drink once more, and he says, "All right, I've been looking for three mercs with a very specific skill set, and Roland says that at least two of you he knows are trustworthy, and Jackson." I know your. I've got your resume from the Relentless, okay? They say you're a pretty decent crewman and a decent shot. So, I have a proposition for you guys. If you'll hear me out, you know, you can decide what you want to do. If you don't want to, if you want to walk away right now, that's cool as well. I don't mind. But just hear me out. And he pours you another drink. And, do you all make body checks, actually? This is your third drink. So, make body checks to not get hammered.
Oh god.
No, that's good.
Jackson's alright. Yeah, that's fine.
Oh no, I haven't rolled yet.
Okay.
Oh dear lord.
What's your body?
What's your body?
4.
Okay, right. Would you say Damon's a big bloke? Is he quite brawny or is he quite small?
He's kinda big. He grew up with the farm life, so he's kinda like a farm boy.
So yeah, he's tipsy, like, you know, he's getting a nice buzz on, and Shireen just like looks at him and just tufts and rolls her eyes and has a little smirk on her face, and but you can tell he's got a bit of a buzz on now, and Jared Blake like leans forward and he says, "Well, this is my bar, all right, and if you do this job for me, you'll get free drinks in here for the rest of your lives, but also." You know, I'm not going to let you go uncompensated. And he goes, here. And he gets up this this flyer. It's like a map. And he slides it across the bar. He taps a location where there's a black line running through an amber waste. And he says, the nine ways line bullion train will be passing through this area at 3:20 p.m. tomorrow. At a place called Sulker's Overpass. About 3 miles in that direction. I mean, like, thumbs a direction to the west. He says, I need you guys to stop that train, and I need you to get 3 crates for me. That's it. I don't want any of the gold bullion. It brings too much heat down on us. I just need 3 crates. 3 crate numbers. If you accept the job, I'll give you the crate numbers. Alright? And... I'm willing to pay you, say, $500 for each crate. So that'd be $500 each. But, I would much prefer if this train got robbed without them even knowing that they got robbed. If you can somehow stop that train and get my crate without anyone knowing, I'll up your reward to $800 a crate. Any questions?
What are in these crates?
He basically says, just old tech, alright? They're not gonna... They're really not gonna miss 3 crates of old tech, but these are 3 components that I really need for a project that I'm working on at the moment.
What's the project?
He said, well, I'm afraid that's none of your business.
Just a curious one. Gotta know what I'm getting into.
Oh, it's nothing illegal, but then nothing's illegal in the Driftwood. Men make their own laws. But it's nothing untoward. It's just, you know, everyone wants a bigger gun, right? And I'm just like, shrugs, yeah. Smiles.
What kind of opposition can we expect?
The guards and the train are generally professional. And there'll be anywhere from about 20 to 30, but it's a big train, alright? So I'd say the last estimate that I had on the train as it was leaving the station about 3 days ago was about 12 carriages. So 30 guards spread across that, you know, let's say 3 guards a carriage, maybe, every other carriage. So they should be, you know, relatively spread out. They're going to be pros, they're going to have their own equipment. And if you agree to the job, I've got your own equipment that you can keep. You can keep the stuff I give you. Call it an investment.
Alright.
Does anyone else have any questions?
Shireen just has this vacant smile on her face at the mention of old tech.
Yeah.
That's about it.
See, the thing is, old tech could be anything. It could be a fucking toaster.
She doesn't really care.
Toasters are cool.
Yep. Give me a sec. Yeah, so, you guys are, you can take the job. You don't need to take the job. This is out of the game now. Completely up to you what you do. Just let me know. You guys can, he says, hey, I'll let you guys discuss it yourself. I mean, you've never met before, okay? So, but you all come highly recommended. So, you know, you guys, just have a word with Susie here. And the old woman that Shireen met before, like, walks in. Says, yeah, just have a word with Susie and she'll set you up with drinks while you talk. I'm going to go serve my other customers. I'll be back in a sec. And he gets up. As he walks away, you can see that he's like in his mid-40s. You know, and he has graying hair and a lot of stubble all over his face. And you can tell he's a mechanic. He's got, like, oil all over his apron. So like that. But he's also damn decent barman, you know, the way he pours the drinks and stuff. But you guys can now talk among yourselves, see what you want to do.
Well, to me, the sound of getting equipment and paid sounds pretty good. So, I'm in.
Anyone else have anything to say?
What's the dollar system like in this game? Like,
The dollar system is basically like a really high-end rifle. In this game, is around $2,500. An airship would be around $10,000. You know, armor-piercing rounds are $1,500, but the stuff that you're looking at will be about $100, $125. For like a 9mm pistol or 9mm hand cannon, and those would be enough to you know, scare normal guards into backing down and stuff, you know.
Okay, I was just wondering if this was like a fairly decent chunk of change for what he's offered.
$500 would get you well drunk for a month probably, and or you could go and upgrade your stuff. You know, you can go and get, you could go and buy yourself like a double shotgun, which is, you know, a pristine condition double shotgun, and some decent armor. But he's already giving you equipment and armor, so, you know, you could just go and augment what you already have, or even just keep the money and save it. You know, it's up to you. I mean, a normal house would be around, depending on the state of the house, like a shack would be about $200. You know, so you could go and get yourself a shack or something. Whereas a really an old world home, which has been renovated, will be about 2,000.
Okay, all right. It's good information to know. So, Damien is gonna say, "Yeah, it seems like some good money. I think I'm down to go for it."
Does Shireen still have a vacant smile on her face from?
Pretty much.
Yeah.
Looks well, like
by the look on her face, I think she's into.
All right.
I don't know her name.
So, Jared Blake comes back, and he says, "So, have you guys made a decision?"
Yeah, we're in.
He goes, "All right, good. Come with me." And he waves you behind the bar, and says, "Come with me. We'll talk some business."
So, yeah, I guess we're following him.
Okay.
Or I am, anyway.
Yeah, it's up to you.
Yeah, I'm also following.
Cool.
Yeah.
So, you guys go into the back room of this bar in the center of it. And he says, "Right." And he slams a red button. And the bottom of the bar, like, this is in the back room, so no one can see it. The bottom of the bar, like, drops away to a staircase. And he goes down. And you end up in an enclosure just over here. And there is a van there, and three horses, and three crates. He says, "The horses are yours to keep. They're pretty good destroyers, you know, they're worth about 250 each. So you could sell them off the mission if you really want. The van will do you for about $300. But that's also yours to keep. And the three crates hold, you know, your equipment for the mission if you accept it. And, you know, as I say, don't be thanking me too much. There's no skin off my nose. This is really low-end stuff for what I have. But, you know, it's my pleasure. You're the ones taking the risk, so you guys get out there and do your thing." And he goes, I'll leave you guys the gear up and I'll come back in a sec. Just give me a sec." And he walks off back into the bar to sort out something.
Okay.
Do you guys want to know what's in the weapon crates?
Yes.
Yes.
Do you guys have your rules up? The rules?
Yes.
Go to the equipment page. In pistols and handguns, there are basically all of the pistols in the game are in there. So, you know, one for each of you, if you were to select that. There is a single shotgun and a double shotgun in there. There is a Driftwood Bolter machine gun, basically. And there is a hammer rifle in there. And there is no sniper rifles, and there's one grenade lobber as well. And in terms of blades, there is a double blade and a phase dagger in there.
Yeah. Well, these guys look like they're more proficient in weapons, so I'll let them pick first. Right.
And in one of the other crates, there are as a street mercenary gear, there is street operative gear, and there's a Kevlar-laced trench coat. So you can have one of those each. You know, you can choose which one you want.
So, for armor, there's street mercenary and street operative?
Mm-hmm, yeah. And the Kevlar lace trench coat. The first three, basically.
Okay. I am going to take the Kevlar lace trench coat for my armor.
You can select what, you know, color you want it in.
Well, I'm just gonna go with the color I picked for my guy, just to make it easier. And as far as weapons go, I want the blade.
Okay.
The double blade.
Double blade. Okay, that's cool. The way carrying works, you can carry two small weapons and one large one, basically. And if you invest in a backpack, you can carry two large ones.
Okay. My character is going to be like, I mean, you've played Borderlands 1 and 2, right?
Yeah.
Like, I'm trying to gear him towards Mordecai and Zero.
Okay.
Type.
Yeah.
So, like, pistols, sniper rifle, and sword.
Okay, that's cool.
So.
Yeah, so double blade is pretty good. Basically two swords in one thing.
Alright.
In fact, it's very good for your level. It'll pretty much one hit most things.
All right. Since I picked a weapon already, does someone else want to pick a weapon?
Yeah. I mean, there's enough to go around, so you're not going to miss out on stuff. You can.
Okay.
Generally.
I just didn't know if there was like one of.
No. Everything. There's three of each. There's three of each.
Okay.
So, yeah. And when you guys look up, you can see guards posted above you with like, you know, they've got like rifles out just in case you try anything, to, like put your stuff in the van and drive away. Like they're all like, there's about five of them. They're not aiming anything at you, they're just, you know, generally walking around.
And you said there was no sniper rifles?
No, not at the moment.
There's a normal rifle, though, I think.
Oh, no, there is. Yeah, there's a south sniper. A south sniper.
Okay, I want that.
Yeah. That's cool.
Alright, I'm probably going to take some street operative gear.
Yeah.
Did you ever stat the pistol that I had in my bio?
I did. Let me just have a little look and get in there. I'll just type it into the thingy. I'll copy and paste it over.
Alright,
so, Dean.
Yes.
Since I have the double blade that counts as two small, and then the sniper will be the one large. Okay.
Yeah.
Alright, that works.
You can just forego having two small ones and just have a double blade and a sniper rifle. It just means that your double blade will like almost always be in your hand rather than...
What do you mean?
Well, like, you can't... If something's big, you sling it over your back. So you either have your sniper rifle slung over your back or you have your sword slung over your back. You can't, like... Do you know what I mean? You can't hip holster it or either of those two things. So as long as you're okay with having your sword out constantly, you should be alright. You're fine.
Okay.
Or you can spend your $50 on a backpack and throw your rifle in there and sling your sword over your back.
Alright, if I did that, would I be able to acquire a pistol as well?
Yeah. Or no? Yeah.
Okay, then I'm gonna do that. Okay. Get a backpack.
Epilogue. There we go. Ah, where's the thing? There we go. There it is.
What's the stat for the backpacks? Just two slots or something?
Yeah. You can get, hang on a second. There you go. That's Damien's pistol. Yeah, so you can chuck two heavy weapons, larger weapons, into your backpack and have stuff holstered over your hip. Well, basically, one of your heavy weapons goes in your backpack, the other one is slung over your back, and you can have a weapon on your hip as well. That's basically how it works.
Can you tell me one more time which pistols and handguns are available?
All of them?
Oh, all of them?
Yep.
Okay.
Yeah, then I'm gonna get a pistol as well, then. Yeah, I think I'm gonna put the sniper in the backpack and, like, you know, just use it when I'm far away, obviously. And,
Shireen, you look inside the van, and you can see it's like a really sickly light green color, do you know what I mean, like pre-war all over, but you can see see in the front, like, it's got a full tank of gas and it's got a full engine of water, so you should be okay to run it. You know, it's not going to blow up on you as soon as you get out there, and the horses look well fed and well conditioned as well.
That's good.
There is a trailer on the back of the van, so there is a space to put the crates in the back of the van. And attached to the back of the van is a trailer for your horses, if you want to put the horses in there. It's up to you. You can look in the glove compartment as well, and you find... Da-da-da-da-da. Yeah, you find 8 sticks of dynamite, long fuse dynamite. But you can cut the fuse shorter if you want.
Okay. And can we dual wield pistols?
Yes.
Alright, I figured. Okay, so I will take...
I want you guys to sort this out, seeing yourselves, for the next 5 minutes. We'll take a quick break, and I'll go get myself a drink. Okay. I'll leave the stream running, though. It's cool.
Okay.
Alrighty. I think I've decided what I'm going to take.
What's that?
I have my gun that I got from my father in the... in my bio.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to take a needle pistol and the hammer rifle. I think he said the hammer rifle was in it.
Yeah, it was.
Okay, yeah, I'm going to take the hammer rifle and the needle pistol.
Okay. I'm going to take, since I bought the backpack, I'm going to take the south sniper, keep it in there unless I need it. The double blade, and then one 10mm stopper on my hip.
Alright. I'll take the... He said the... Did he say the Driftwood bolter was there?
For what?
For machine weapons?
Yes.
Okay, so I'm taking that and 2 of the 10mm pistols.
The 10mm stoppers?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I grabbed that because my guy's like range driven, basically. So.
Hey, Sammy, when you sent Dean the copy for me, did you send him that I took Conduit of Power or Channeling Jump?
Whatever one you told me you took.
Yeah, I don't remember. I was at work when I told you which one to...
My god. Okay, let me check. Channeling jump and stabilizing presence are your gambits.
Okay, cool. Alright, you guys do that. I'm gonna use the bathroom.
Have fun.
So I'm going to cut that.
Okay, and then I'll take the street operative gear. I think that seems more like Shireen armor than a trench coat.
Yeah, that's kind of how I was feeling the same way, because my guy doesn't want to look like he's a mage.
Yeah, I could see that for Chance's character. He's kind of like, oh, you know, I'm a space pirate.
Trench coats and guns.
Trench coats are cool.
Yeah, no, my guy just doesn't want to look like he's a mage, so he's trying to keep a low key on his clothing profile.
Inventory. There we go. Okay, stream. Okay. Yeah, I think I'm done with my stuff. For now.
I'm back.
Yay.
I hate to say it, but I think I'm getting sick.
Oh.
Okay.
I've been sick.
What is it with Americans and everyone being sick today? It's weird. I think everyone's been ill at some point today, though. If Tim's been ill... And then
down here in Texas, at least, the weather is finally changing back to cold from like 90s and hundreds in Fahrenheit.
Fuck that, I hate the heat.
Yeah, so and it's humid here, like really humid.
Yeah. It's the same in Britain. We get like, yeah, it's sticky, wet heat. It's horrible.
Yeah.
In South Africa, though, it was dry heat, so you wouldn't even sweat. It would just go. That means you burn like that, you know, really, really quickly, but it also means you don't really sweat, so...
Yeah, Tahoe's dry heat.
Yeah.
When it actually gets...
I prefer that.
Alright, so is everyone geared up? Ready to go?
Yes.
Yep.
Yeah.
Alright, so you guys saddle up. What do you guys want to do with the horses? Like Jared comes back out and says, hey, off for the trip. And he like throws you all like canisters of water. He goes, you'll be needing that. It's hot as fuck out here.
Appreciate it.
I agree.
And he goes, remember, 3:20 tomorrow we'll be passing through this area, right? And if you
sounds
get,
good.
And if you get caught, who gave you this job?
What job?
Thank you very much. I'll see you in a couple of days, alright? And he walks back into his bar and stuck shut to the door. You can tell that he's done this about a million times with the different mercenaries, just sending them out in little jobs to get these equipments for him. Get some equipment. Mm-hmm. So what do you guys want to do with the horses? Because you guys are just milling around the courtyard now.
I don't know. I think we're needing the van to get the crates. I don't know that dragging a giant trailer with horses in it would be a good idea right now.
Okay.
Like, we're coming back here anyway. What do you guys think?
Yeah, probably leaving the horses here so that we can get away in a more timely fashion would be a good idea. I mean, unless we're going to take the horses to get away with, but we have a car, so.
Well, what are we going to do? Like, strap the crate to the horse's back?
Yeah, no. That's gonna work. That'd be kind of cruel and unusual.
I don't know. But someone might steal them if we leave them here.
Well, there's guards posted by, so I don't think anyone's going to be stealing from some...
Okay. Hello, Gargamond. Hello. So yeah. You guys going to leave the horses here?
Yes. I'm good with that.
Okay, okay. Well, You guys take the van out and a shutter door comes up and allows you to pass through, and you start going through like a really arid desert landscape. You can see like fallen cities in the distance, like raking towards the sky, like these skeletons are standing there really awkwardly. And eventually you come to an overpass called... I've lost my thing. Where am I? Where's my thing? There it is. Yeah.
Shouldn't lose.
Yeah. yes. It's called Sulker's Overpass, and that's the bit of the map that Jared marked for you. And so, you guys can see the train line running quite clearly through the middle of this place. I'm going to do the map for you now. There you go. You should all be seeing. None of this is being covered up because you can pretty much see. yeah. The Nine Ways Rail Line. So this central line running through the middle is where the train line is, and this is Sulker's overpass here.
Okay.
The train's going to be coming from this direction down to here, and then pass all the way through. Okay.
Okay. All right.
So, you guys are approaching, you're approaching from this direction, generally. So, I'll tell you what I'll do, I'll get a nice picture of a van for you. There we are.
Make it as rapey as possible.
Oh, if there's one thing Dean knows, it's rapey.
Okay.
Oh my god.
okay. Oh, it's all white. Why is it all white?
Hey, Tim.
Yeah.
What's the candy for?
The children.
Tim? What's the shovel for?
Also the children.
that was the best.
Alright. So you guys are coming from that direction now. That's the van. And,
okay.
The van's a bit small now, actually, because the train's fucking massive and the van isn't as big as the train. So.
I know, the van looks pretty huge compared to the train line.
This is the van!
It looks like it's smiling at us.
Because it is.
It does.
It's
and it has
man.
Little arms, too.
It's a toaster. It's the brave little toaster van.
It does look like that, doesn't it?
You can call it the brave little toaster van if you wish. It's there.
Yeah, so. I think that's a good name.
It's perfect.
Yeah.
The brave little toaster van that could.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm thinking we should put the van behind one of these, like, things. Mm-hmm. So that the train can't see it, because it's coming this way.
Who's driving, by the way?
I don't know.
I can.
All
since right. Sam
give
and
me
Mara
a give
did
me a break from
Minerva.
Driving all the time. I'm okay with that.
Yeah.
Yeah, chance can drive.
Wait, what's your
that
perception?
Works
my perception is 2. No, I'm just kidding.
That's not drive anywhere.
No, it's 7.
Cool. We should be alright.
Okay.
All right.
Yeah, mine's 8, so
this
I'm
is actually a downward slope here, so you're gonna have to roll to drive across it, to not turn the van over. So that would be one way of creating a roadblock, you know, just rolling the van down the hill, but
that doesn't really give us the element of surprise, though.
Well, yeah. We're robbing your train!
Or, you know, we could make it look like put Shireen out there, like, help me, oh my god, my van! And then,
you could do that.
Know, and then the guy
slams into you.
What, like, yeah. Are you talking like Breaking Bad-esque there, about, like, putting the van on the railway and going, hey, sorry, what the odds, huh? And,
oh, I actually forgot about that.
Yeah.
But yeah, that did happen.
Yes, it did.
If that's what you think.
Great show. Great show.
Why don't you ping the map where you want to take the van, and I will make you roll accordingly.
What do you guys think?
I think we need to put the van somewhere where the train can't see it.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Like behind.
So what is this area right here?
That's the Sulkers Overpass. That's like elevated land. So basically, it goes down this way, then all of a sudden it goes into like a sharp upturn around here, and then this is higher land.
We also have dynamite too, you guys. I forgot
about
that.
Yes, you do have dynamite.
And I'm assuming this area right here is trees, bushes.
Yes, trees and bushes. Yeah. Desert foliage that can survive out here, basically. You've got another 15 minutes till the train gets here. And if you decide what you want to do before then I'll just speed her up and it'll come quicker. Whenever you're ready, it'll come, basically.
How fast is this train going?
It's a big carriage train. It's a cargo train, so not very quick. It's about 30 miles an hour. Which is quick for, you know, compared to going over land with a horse and carriage, but the main advantage of train lines is that they go from A to B. Like, there's no, it's like as the crow flies, you know?
Yeah.
So that's why they get where they need to go quicker. As long as the driver had prior warning, you can sort of gauge that he would be able to stop in time. Of an obstruction. But remember what the guy said, what Jared said, you know, he'd rather you didn't raise suspicion. That you just got on and got off. Oh, and by the way, I forgot to give you the numbers for the crates that you're after, so I will do that now. 186. So.
Oh, I should probably take note of this.
I'm going to type them in. 186. You're looking at 298 and 401.
Okay.
And thank you to Talus Wind there. You can hold Alt to resize off-grid lines. So, but I'll do that in a minute. Other than that.
So I want to know how we're going to get on this train, personally, without it stopping if it's going 30 miles an hour.
Isn't the idea to make it stop? I thought that was what we were doing.
Well, I mean, that would work, but how?
We could blow up the overpass. No.
We could, like, set the dynamite up at the top of one of the things and create, like, a blockage with rubble.
That would be a natural hazard, yeah. They wouldn't suspect that.
Yeah, make it look like a landslide happened, like rocks fell onto the track. They got to clear it out so we can get in, get out, get our stuff.
That's kind of what I was thinking. You just toned my idea down a bit.
Your idea was to blow up the overpass.
Yeah, let's do that.
Mm-hmm. All right. So, all right. How do you ping?
You hold left
click. Yeah, you just hold it down.
Okay. Cool.
All right, where should we put the van then? Like maybe behind here so they can't see it when they're coming?
Probably. Yeah. We want to definitely move it into a spot where they're not going to see it when they're coming or when they're going.
Yeah. I like either here.
Oh, wait. What about here? Or... Because it's kind of blocked like on this end and it's kind of blocked on... this end.
Yeah, that works.
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay, are you set on a location? Just ping it for me. When you've
right there.
Right there? Okay. So you're gonna have to drive down this slope and gauge it carefully. So I'm gonna make you drive to here. So roll your perception and I'll move you there if you succeed. Okay, that's fine. You were there. I'll let you go a bit further, actually, because that was a good roll. And now, just to get across the tracks over to here, do another one. What is your perception? No, yeah, you're fine. Yeah,
7.
You're across. Yeah, you're across. It's fine. And then just to swing around here into position, another one. Yeah, it's fine. And you park the van up here.
Right there.
Yeah. There you go. I can't actually put it there because it's not.
Okay.
Oh, there you go. There
good
you go.
Enough.
There
good you go. Enough.
All right. So I assume you're gonna park it so like the back of the truck is facing like that way, so you can drive straight away.
Yeah.
Okay. And I'll move you out a bit so you can actually get around, or you'd have to go up the slope to do to get the. So you can go like there.
So.
Okay.
It should be obscured from the view of the train there, right?
It is, yeah.
Okay. I just want to make sure I'm not reading the landscape wrong.
So, what do you guys want to do next?
I say we should set up some, like, explosives here to create some rubble on the tracks.
Okay, so you guys all get out of the, you all get out the van and you're generally, like milling around looking at the landscape. Damien, why don't you go ahead and roll, because... Do the guys know the plan, right? You guys are like full in on the plan?
Yes.
Yeah, we discussed it.
Okay. So, Damon, you use your perception to see where you can put these dynamite sticks in this overpass, just to make sure that you can get it.
You said perception, correct?
Yes, just because you're looking to see where things are. What perception are you?
Of 7.
Okay, well that's okay. So you can see like a few fault lines in the rock, like up here and around here, and you can sort of gauge with the because Jackson's there with you and he has a good perception, and so does Shireen. You can all look at it and you're all gauging where, and you can see there should be. Let me do a. You can see that there's fault lines like all over it, so if you put 4 down one side and 4 down the other side, you should be okay. So you just want to ping where you want to put the dynamite, and you'll have to climb to put it in, so you'll have to do body checks to get up there to put it in. It's all long fuse dynamite too, so You will have to light it, and then you'll have a minute to light them all, to climb to them all and light them before they explode.
That sounds bad.
Because long fuse dynamite, if something explodes near it, it doesn't explode itself. The fuse needs to go in. That's why it's long fuse. It's basically to make sure, like in the Old West, when they were mining, to make sure that the accidents were lessened, the long fuse dynamite was introduced, because if there was an explosion next to normal dynamite, it would just go off. It would just, like, you know, react to the heat, whereas long fuse dynamite keeps everything inside the TNT. So it needs to be lit deliberately rather than just being.
Well.
So it's up to you how many sticks you use, to be honest.
Can I kind of, like, look at this and determine how much it would take?
You can certainly try with your perception, yeah. That'd be fine.
Oops.
Oh, that's not your role. Alright. Yeah, you can see that four sticks should pretty much do the job. But, you know, then you're looking at, you know, they're going to be able to clear the rubble pretty quickly, whereas six would be, it would do the job and it would take them a while, and eight would be, they won't be leaving for a few hours. They'll need to clear the overpass for a few hours.
Okay.
And you can relay that information to the other guys if you wish, or you can keep it to yourself. It's up to you.
I will tell them.
Okay.
Well, obviously, the more time we have,
the better
off we're going to be.
Yeah, I agree.
Alright,
who has the... I don't know. I think Jackson and I have the highest body.
Oh, my body sucks, so...
Well, mine's only five, so...
Well, I've got four.
I'm at a five.
Yeah, okay. So I guess Jackson and I should go.
Yeah, four each.
Yeah.
You can plant them and then light them as you go. That might be a better way of doing it.
Yeah. What happens if we go over?
How do you mean? What happens if they go off?
No, like, what happens if we roll over our body?
Well, we'll see. You'll probably fall. But we'll see.
Okay.
As I said, it depends on the roll you make. You can fail, but it'll be not as bad a fail, so you can actually catch on to something. You know, it's not like a...
Yeah.
Roll natural 100 or something then.
Alright, let's go.
Alright, so you've got four sticks each. Who's taking which side?
I'll take this side.
You've got 5 minutes before the
That's not
before you. The train gets here.
Alright. Fine, I'll take the far away side. See
okay.
how it is.
Okay. So you're Shireen's taking that side, and... Okay, so we'll do Jackson first. Yeah, start your climb. Do your body check for me. It's your first fissure in the rock. Your body is what?
Five.
Okay, that's fine. You climb up there, and you slam the first stick of dynamite into place. You can choose to light it now and move on to the next one, or you can... You'll have a minute once you've lit it.
No, I'm going to wait.
Okay. So, Shireen, you have your first body check, please. Okay, that's really good. You just vault up and just, like, hang on with one hand and slam the dynamite into the fissure with the other one. You can now... Actually, I'll let you move on. I'll let you move on further up as well, so you slam another one in. So you've now slammed two sticks of dynamite in. Yeah, so you've got two left. You can light the first one if you wish, or it's up to you.
I thought we were trying to roll under our body.
You are.
See? Okay, I'm looking. Never mind, I didn't multiply it.
Yeah,
never mind.
Yeah. That's cool. So, Jackson, you roll your next one, please. Oh, no, identical. Okay, so you go up to the next one and you slam it in. And you look behind you, and a bead of sweat drops down your forehead. As you can see Damien down there on the valley floor. And he's like calling up to you, like saying, "Are you okay?" And then you look over to the distance and you can see a train approaching in the far distance. So it's not gonna be here for another couple of minutes. So what do you guys want to do?
I think we should start lighting it and just book.
So Jackson, you shout across to... You do what you want, actually. You do what you want. Fine. What do you want to do?
Okay.
Oh, yeah, I have a question. So I'm assuming, like, comms and stuff don't exist. So if, like, we're... Like, if he's here
They do, for example, screaming at each other? Don't have any, but you can't shout to each other. You can't shout to each other.
So right now we're just yelling at each other?
Yeah, pretty much.
Okay.
I'm gonna start lighting mine.
Okay. All right. I'm just gonna keep.
It'll be here any minute.
So, are you guys gonna start lighting yours?
Yeah.
You've got 3 minutes.
Okay. Yeah, I think I.
So, Shireen, you've lit the first one. Do you want to move on to do your third? And then
you're like, I just rolled for it, but I think I failed.
What's your body?
5.
You lose your footing a little bit. I'll let you roll again, because it's not a critical fail, not a bad one. That's better. So you get your footing again, and now just reach up and slam the dynamite in. I need you to roll one more. That dynamite is wedged, but not in the exact place that you wanted it. But you can now light your final dynamite if you wish.
Okay.
So
was my third, right?
Third. Yeah. The one at the bottom isn't lit, so you need to go down
there.
There's
my last one.
Okay, so on the way down, so it's you like to slide down the rock, but you keep your footing, and you light the last one, and then step off. So your three are lit now. Now, Jackson, this is happening simultaneously, so, you know, don't worry. So, what do you want to do? Because you've slammed two into the rock, haven't you? And you haven't lit them yet, so what do you want to do?
I want to light them and press on.
Okay, so you light the one that you're on, and then do another body check for me to climb up.
Yes.
Okay, you are, like, hanging by your fingertips, so do another one for me. Okay, yeah. You regain your balance and you jump up onto the next part and you slam your dynamite in and you light it. And now do a body check to get down, just to slide down the slope. Oh, another one, please. Oh, okay.
Oh my god.
All right. You slam into the floor and only from about 30 feet, and you take 5 harm that completely bypasses your armor. Value. So
what does that mean exactly?
Well, did you know your vitality points are basically your life, your HP. Then you take 5 points away from that. So basically like
I didn't calculate what my vitality points were.
Let me have
10.
Look. Yeah, you have 10. So you have 5 left basically.
Okay.
So basically just to put it into context, a single shot from a shotgun at close range will kill you outright at the moment.
Yes.
but pistols will take 2 rounds to kill you, whereas. Right. So
the goal is don't get hit.
Yeah, as always. All right. So, you can light the last one if you wish, but you'll need to do another quick body check. You've got 1 minute. I imagine Shireen's already running the fuck out of the...
Yes.
Okay, you light your last one.
Absolutely.
So you guys are running out of the place where you are. And the train... The phallic train of doom. Whoops. Phallic train.
Going the wrong way.
Big ass train. Derailed.
It's about here now. It's about here. So, it gets to around... do you want to position yourselves on the map for me?
I went back to the van.
Okay, so you're in the van. Anyone else?
I am... right over here.
Okay. Just watching out with your binoculars and... All right, and Jackson, where are you?
Right there.
Mm-hmm. Okay, The pass is annihilated in a rumbling explosion that basically creates a no-pass zone here. So, falling rock basically makes the pass not usable at all. And the train driver sees that, and the train starts to slow down. And eventually it comes to a stop around about here. I can't put it directly onto the thing, so I'll just put it there like that. So it's at a direct stop.
Okay.
In fact, I'll probably just do this. Just like that. It's like at a direct stop there.
Okay.
Right. Well, does anyone have any ideas how to get on the train now? Or actually, can I roll perception to see where the cargo might be?
Yeah.
Can I roll reception?
I probably don't see it. I have 8 perception.
No, you know you don't see it. You don't see
it. I'm gonna check and see if there's any people outside the train already, like looking around and stuff.
Yep. You don't need to roll for that. You just like look. And you can see that there are several guards that have just jumped out of the train and are, like, scanning up and down the train.
Alright, I'm gonna roll perception, too. To see what I can see. Mine's 7.
Okay, yeah, you can see not only are the guards out of the thing, but you can see banners flapping in the wind in the distance. Give me a second. And you can actually see that there are several trucks on the way from this direction up here.
Okay.
And what's your gangland knowledge like? You know, of different like gangs and stuff.
Real life?
No. Just like in Driftwood, like, would you know many of them?
I know of them.
Okay.
I think if anyone knows, it'd probably be Damien, because he's
been,
like... Yeah,
I've got a lot of gang knowledge and stuff like that because of tracking down the Band of Brass.
Well, what do you want to say anything, Jackson, about what you've seen? Because you can just see like the dust on the horizon, are they just like coming towards this overpass?
I see 3 trucks. One looks more like a big rig type truck. Another looks like a armored type truck, like maybe an armored car or an ambulance or something. And then another one is just a regular truck that has a lot of blood on it.
All right, and what kind of banners do you see on it?
You can roll perception if you wish to see if you can spot the banner on it. Okay, that's fine. You see a but they're basically big shards of brass that's like hanging off all of the separate vehicles, and they're basically they look like things that have just been cobbled together and hammered on over the years. And the guys in there don't look very friendly. They look quite annoyed.
These guys look mean, and there's shards of brass hanging off the sides of all the trucks. So, does that tell you anything?
Yeah, it should. I just rolled.
Roll for tears.
75. Fail.
Yeah.
So is that going to be the Band of Brass, or
you have 1 pair of binoculars that Jackson was using, so you can ask for them if you want to verify for yourself.
All right. Hey, Jackson, can I see those binoculars real quick so I can get a better look at them?
Yeah, here you go.
Right, so it's a roll of perception, but take 20 off your score. So it's basically a buff because you're using the... and you know what you're looking for as well.
All right.
So... Oh, yeah. You can
negative
see
one.
You can see that not only is this the band of brass that you know of, but in this truck here, their leader, Frederick Backfire, who you've known of for years, like he's actually leading this raiding party that have spotted this train and are moving in on it, and they're quite close now. They're getting closer. Like they're cutting off behind, like this truck has pulled off and is cutting off the retreat of the guards.
Alright, so that is definitely the Band of Brass.
Okay, well, what do you know about them?
Who are these guys?
Those are the bastards who ruined my hometown, killed my parents, and I don't even know what they did to my brother, but we never found him.
So needless to say, these aren't guys you want to be messing with.
Shireen is feeling really bad right now because like they basically just put this train in danger. I mean, well, they need to get the job done.
For all you know, I mean, the Manderbrush were planning this all along to seize the train. You guys are just unlucky enough to get on the same target, you know? But
yeah, that's true. But at least, never mind. It's fine. Let's go.
I think we need to wait and see what happens before this escalates any further, because I don't want to be seen by both the guards on the train and the Band of Brass. So.
Okay. Well, are you guys ascending to that plan, or are you not? What do you want to do?
What do you think, guys?
I don't know. We might be able to use them as a distraction to sneak on.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, so we wait and see what they do, and dependent on how they act, you know, then we can act.
Okay, well, a vote of 2-1 means that's what the party will be doing, but Damien, you don't have to lock yourself in to what they're doing if you want. You can do your own thing. It's up to you. How would he react to this news? He'd be pretty pissed, I assume.
Yeah, Damien's incredibly enraged because he's been looking for these people for over 2 years now. Mm. And for them to finally show up while he's doing a mission, he's just... Yeah, he's angered that...
At the GM. It's like that, cursing the heavens. No!
Like, finally after he gave up looking for them, like, he stopped looking for them to try to take care of his sister, to take care of the family that he's still got. But now they just appear. Mm-hmm. He's torn.
Okay. Well, let's see how things unfold then, and we'll see if you want to move in and do other things. Because time goes on. And the Band of Brass basically cut off the line of retreat, and they come this way like this. And Frederick Backfire, let's call him Backfire for now, he just like jumps out and starts like ordering his men to surround the thing, and all the guards turn around, and like there's like a standoff for a while until the guards realize that they're outnumbered by the Band of Brass, and so they lay down their guns. What you guys can see, because you're using the blockers to look inside the train, the numbers of the guards on the train were woefully overestimated by Jared Blake. Like, there'll be about 15 in there, if that, because they're outnumbered by there's about 20 of these barbarian tribesmen, and there's about 15 guards outside, and they put their weapons down. And instead of stop me whenever you want to do something, by the way, taking their surrender. Like, Backfire just orders them to be shot. Just, like, turns around and just says, have at it. And the guys just, like, unload their machine guns on the
Oh, shit.
On the helpless guards, and they cut them down, and that they run onto the train and start like pushing through the train.
Well, all right. That didn't go well. We need to move, I think.
Yeah, and how many band of brass were left by their vehicles at this point?
There are about four, just keeping Dixie by the vehicles. Do you want me to draw them for you? Because I'll draw them.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So yeah, there's one dude just there. That dude's a bit bigger than the rest, but fuck it. So yeah, those are the five guys that are around the vehicles. Actually, the big one's Backfire. He's the main guy. He's just directing things from where he is.
All right, where's the high ground?
Right. You're on the high ground, and there is high ground here and here. Basically, the pass is the high ground.
Okay. I think you guys should move in, and I'll cover you with my sniper rifle. Try and pick off as many of these guys outside as possible, and then I'll meet back up with you once they're cleared out. Okay. Unless you have a better plan.
Not particularly. So,
Damien?
Nah, I don't have a better plan.
Okay. Alright, before you engage them, kind of peer in to the train. Like, sneak up to it and peer in. And, like, try to get a head count of how many are inside.
Yeah, I was...
I'd be remiss, but you also have two sticks of dynamite, remember? That are long fuse, so you can plant them and move away before they explode. If you ever want to do that.
Yeah, I wanted...
You had eight, and used six.
Oh, okay. So then... Okay, let's both... Like, we each take a stick of dynamite in case we need it, I think.
Yeah.
Sneak very carefully toward the train.
Alright, so are you going to sneak down the slope? Down the blind side of the train? Or are you going to come the whole way around this way?
Yeah, I'm
thinking of going
down
this
the blind
way.
Side.
Okay, yeah. So you're sneaking this way. So you'll put your characters there for me. And I would probably make you do...
Perception?
Yeah, perception, just to find your footfalls and to go down nice and quietly.
My perception is 8.
Okay, that's good. So, Damien now?
Well, it's not letting me move my guy, so I'm just going to draw a new one.
Yeah, just draw a new one, it's fine.
It's a glitch it has. And then you can also move with the arrow keys, I found out last time.
Mm-hmm. All right, so I'm going to move down here, and I need to roll, correct?
Yes.
Yeah.
Just move, roll your...
Oh, God.
You're in free fall, my friend. roll again, just to see if you can... Yeah, okay. So, yeah, you slide down, and you are now here in front of the train. You slide past Shireen, who tries to catch you and just goes, "Ah, fuck." As you go, and you slide down, and you just like come to a stop face first in the dirt. And I'm gonna roll to see if one of the guys has seen you.
Oh my god.
They have not. So you are good. I rolled an 89 there. So you're okay.
Okay.
They're too enamored with looting the train than they are with actually coming across.
So, Dean, at this point, they can't confer with me at all.
They can
not
do,
unless we shout.
But they would probably raise the alarm.
Yeah, that's what I mean.
They can give you like hand signs, shit.
Okay.
You guys are trained in that, it's up to you. I'd say they can't. It'll be cool to see you develop as a small unit, and then you can do that later on in campaign.
Okay.
Okay.
So, what you guys want to do?
Continue sneaking.
I'm going to get up and try to peer into the train.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Roll another... actually, what's your... On your highest stat, roll your on your highest stat for me.
Alright, that'd be my magic.
Yeah, so you can, like elude yourself. You can, like, you know, make... Pull your magic around you to smother your physical aura from them as you go past.
Alright.
So you're looking in, and you can see there's about 10 dudes in the train. You're just, like, scanning the train with your magic, you know? And you can see there's 10 dudes, the silhouette of 10 dudes. Like, do you know Hunter Vision? Like, as a vampire in Skyrim, you can get, like, Hunter Vision, where you can see people through walls and stuff. That's what you're doing.
Yeah, or, like, life detect. Or
yeah. That's what you're doing now, and you can see that there's 10 people moving throughout this train. They're just executing people in the train as well. They're not even...
Right.
And the people inside, you can just see that they're not actually warriors, they're clerks and like accountants and stuff that they're just shooting.
Alright.
That's horrible. Yeah,
I'm just ready to provide cover fire. So
I'm going to move over next to Shireen and let her know what I saw in there.
Yeah,
she's not going to be happy about that. Can we tell where the cargo area is?
Do a perception roll for me.
Mine's 8.
Yes, okay. So, you can see that they are numbered from 0 to 100. And you're looking for... you're looking for the... 101 and the 201 and the 401 because of the numbers of the crates that you're after. And so I will do this. The 101 is here, 201 is here, 101 is here, and the 401 is here. So.
Okay, so we need to go here. Damien, where exactly were those people?
They're scattered throughout the train. Scattered
everywhere.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, there's 10 of them, and there's two in this one here. There's two in this one here. There's three in this one here. And there's four in this one here. Generally ransacking the train.
Oh god, okay.
Can I see into this train with my scope at all?
Yes, you can. You can see through the windows, yeah.
Cool.
Alright, so... No. I guess sneak closer.
Okay. Perception?
Sorry.
That's fine. Yep.
I only have guns. I don't think there's really a way to take them out quietly.
Alright, I'm gonna sneak up as well.
You guys are right by a door, so you can climb up onto the train if you wish.
Okay.
And you can make visual contact with Jackson on top of the ridge. You can just see his scope glinting up there, because he's lying down, just like, covering you.
Yeah.
So you can sign to him if you wish, to do whatever you want.
Honestly, I don't know. I can't see us sneaking past all these dudes.
Yeah, I'm gonna try to sneak my way into sneak my way into the train.
Okay. Let's go for it. Use your perception.
Oh god.
What is your perception? 6, isn't it?
Yeah, my perception is 7.
Oh, well, that's okay. Yeah, I'll roll for them to see if they detect you. That's basically all it does, it lets me try and roll. They do not detect you, so you are now on the train. Okay. So, I will draw the dudes who are on there.
Is my sniper rifle silenced or no? Is it gonna just echo through the?
Yeah, it's not silenced. Well, they yeah, can't see you, so it'll just cause a panic amongst them, which is you know kind of what you want.
I think you need a mod.
Yeah, you can get a mod that sounds.
Okay. All right. I almost called you Mara. Can Shireen see me?
Yeah, I think I
yes.
Can.
Okay, I'm gonna hold up like a thumbs up, kind of.
Okay.
Hand.
Okay.
Do a gun check for me, a dead eye check, just to see if you can hover your crosshairs above one of the barbarian's heads and just level your breathing out so you can
dead eye check.
Yeah.
How do I do that?
It's D100 as normal.
Alright.
Yeah, it's fine. So you steady your breathing and you can pull the trigger whenever you want, and that guy is dead when you pull the trigger.
Alright. Yeah, I'm gonna do that. The guy all the way off on the left.
Okay.
This
cool.
one.
So that one?
That one. Yeah. Okay. Cool. Yeah. Hang on a second. Just, okay, roll your dead eye check.
Didn't I already?
No. That was just a steady of breathing to make sure that you were ready to. just re-roll it. There's like a jam in the thing. You go, ah, fuck. And so you just unjam it.
Mine's a 9 anyway. So.
Yeah, so just re-roll. That's fine. Okay. He's dead. Your shot rings out across the entire valley. And his head just explodes, and in a shade of crimson that you know only the desert and the sun can really you know give you can really describe it for you. It's like just
brain first matter. Blood.
Yeah, just like brain oh matter just God. Spreads everywhere.
And all right.
He goes to the floor, and these guys over here they generally just like are thrown into a panic, and they start like radioing like back and forth. So they just start all like right. running around and. Shit like that, they just start running over here to just check on him. Obviously
do
he's
I
dead.
Have any more shots?
Yeah, you got a full attack round.
Alright, I'm gonna... So, roll to steady my breathing and then roll to actually shoot?
No, that was just for the first one, just to check
okay.
that you were right. So you can just roll to shoot now.
Alright.
And it'll literally cancel dudes.
Okay.
Who are you shooting at?
The one right here.
Okay, yeah. And you rolled a... What was it you rolled?
51.
Okay. Well, let me... there we go. Roll your damage for me. It's just harm. No, you don't need to roll your damage. What harm is it? Your rifle? Your self sniper?
Let me see. It is 20.
And what's the AP value on it?
7.
Yeah, he's dead, and dead as dead can be. I think that's your turn. You guys are now in the train, and the guys in the train like milling around, like running around, trying to see out the window to see. So they're completely unawares, not expecting anyone on the train. They're looking out to see if they can find the sniper. So what do you guys want
to
do?
Let's take this opportunity to try and like sneak around and look for the. That we need.
Yeah, I am going to I'm gonna ready epilogue because I heard Chance shooting, so I
Jackson. I'm Jackson.
Jackson. I heard Jackson shooting, my bad.
Jackson Steel.
Yeah, I hear Jackson shooting, so I'm going to unholster epilogue.
Okay.
And just
I'm gonna say you can't sneak through these guys, because they're checking the same crates as you are. Not checking for the same crates, they're just going through the places that you actually need to go and get the crates. So, like, you're literally going to go in there and they'll see you straight away. So you're in for a fight if you go in there.
Alright, so I am going to, move myself over to the side of one of the openings. Is this like different openings, like different compartments of the train?
Yes, yes, just different compartments.
I'm going to move myself over to the side of one of the openings and peer into the next room, try to see if I can spot one of them.
Okay, you can see two. They're by the window, just looking out the window, checking this ridgeline up here just to see where the shot's coming from. And you can hear like a backfire outside, bellowing orders to get people up there to scan the pass.
Can Damien and I shoot one each at the same time?
Certainly. If you can coordinate that, if you want to coordinate that.
Alright, so I'm willing to just take aim at one of the...
Of
the guards.
You can generally, you're not snipers, you can just fire off your shots. I think you got two shots. Yeah, you got two round. Yeah, you got two actions to perform per round, don't you? So you can fire twice with epilogue if you wish.
All right, yeah, I'm gonna fire at the first guy.
Mhm.
So I gotta roll my dead eye, correct?
Yep. That's a hit, and fire at him again.
Alrighty. Ooh.
Okay, that's a jam. So the first one, it's 9 and 9, isn't it? So it does 9 damage. And
yeah.
It basically, punches through him, he's dead. Because he was taken unawares. So you basically just side shot him into the side of the head. He's dead. Shireen, what do you want to do?
Let's see.
This is happening concurrently, so it's not like he shoots, then you shoot. This is all.
Right.
Is the cock and balls the ringleader?
Yes.
Okay.
What?
if you think that's what a cock and balls looks like, then you need to go to the doctors, my friend.
Okay. Anyway.
Well, out of everything that close, that's the closest.
Yeah. Okay, I get that.
I think I'll use my Driftwood bolter.
Okay.
Why not?
Okay.
So, hold on. Okay.
Yep.
Yeah, I got it.
You can get
two shots?
Yeah, you have two shots, yeah. Okay, ooh.
I also got a 33, so
yeah,
that's a critical hit.
Yeah, that's a critical hit. So, double your damage? Is it double damage? Does it say that on the thing?
I don't remember.
Just double it. So what would the harm be on the... What's the harm on
the harm on that gun is 12.
And the AP is?
3.
So, that's 9 damage, 18 damage, and the next one is 9 damage. He's dead.
How do the crits work in this?
If you roll a double, it's a crit, no matter what it is. So if you roll 99, like, it's a crit. It doesn't matter.
11, 22,
33. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So this compartment is now empty, but the two guys from here, I'm not going to move them over because it's kind of fucking impossible with the way roll 20 does it. But they move into this compartment here, so two more guys have come in. And they see you and like, oh shit! And they just like spray the whole area with fire. And they deal out, it would be 5 harm to Shireen, and 2 harm to Damien. Armor piercing value and stuff, so. That's after AP has gone through, so there's no more damage. That's just it.
Alright, so I'm half dead.
The guys from outside, they can hear what's going on now, so the big guy's gonna come to try and get in, and he gets into there. Put him in there. And these guys. Whoops. Are coming over here to fan up. And now, Chance, you get your combat round now?
Wait, are there guys? Wait, hold on. Okay, no, that's my wolf. Okay.
Can I see both of these guys coming around the side at me?
Yes.
And about how far away are they?
I'd say they're like 50 feet.
Okay. I'm gonna shoot the one closest to me.
Okay. The tick sign is the boss, by the way. Yeah, another shot. That's fine. And now roll for your damage. Bear in mind he's on the side of the slope, so you'll probably like fall down. I know you don't need to roll damage. What was your what's the harm on the thing? Are you getting confused?
20 and yeah, AP is 7.
Yeah, he's dead. He falls down the embankment. And the guy down here, he sees you now. So he can fire on you next turn.
That was my first shot, right?
No, you missed your first shot. You got 78. And then you hit with the second one and killed him.
But my dead eye is 9.
Oh, right, yeah. So you get another couple shots, yeah. Go for it, yeah.
Okay.
Is that 44 a shot? Because that would have been a
no. That one disregard that.
Oh.
He said roll for damage and then.
Okay,
so
the other guy's dead as well. So you just like fire two rounds into these guys' heads and then just explode everywhere. So, people inside the truck, what are you guys doing? Backfire is now in there.
I can see that Shireen is injured, so I'm going to perform stabilizing presence.
Okay. Just do a magic check, just to let that go.
Well, you're injured too.
That's fine. So what happens...
You got way more injured than I did.
So, stabilize... Just tell me what stabilizing presence does, so people know.
Alright, let me get to that section real quick. Alright, stabilizing presence. This is a special gambit that lasts as long as you want it to. You stand in the midst of your allies and allow healing energy of your own magic to wash over them. Every ally within 10 feet regains 3 harm a turn, mm-hmm. so long as you do not move.
Okay,
any
so
movement means this effect is cancelled.
Immediately, Shireen gets back 3 harm. So you get 3 vitality points back. And yeah, okay, that's cool.
It's so nice having a healer.
So you can't move around, but you can shoot if you want to shoot. You can stand there and shoot if you want.
I wasn't finished reading it. My magic is 10, mm-hmm. so it says if you are magic 10. Then you may move, and the party within 10 feet regain 5 harm a turn.
Oh, so Shireen's got another 2
so
harm.
I'm healed. Okay.
Yeah.
Yep.
And you can move, Damien. Awesome. You can do whatever you want. So do you want to just fire on the dudes?
Yeah, I'm going to fire on them.
Okay. Which ones? Because there's 2 normal guys, and there's the big bad dude. He just burst in through the wall, and he's got this like great mask on, and he's just this massive muscular dude with the... He looks like he's got like a harness on, you know, like bootstraps over his chest and stuff, like armor. It's been hammered out with brass and stuff.
All right, I'm gonna attack the lackeys first.
Yep. Okay.
Just to make sure that we're not super outnumbered during the next mm-hmm. turn.
Yep. All right. Fair enough. That's cool. Your damage is 9 and 9. That would kill him outright. He's dead. So one more dead.
Yeah. Alrighty. So how many are left?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and the main guy.
Okay.
Actually, no, he's dead as well. So 5 and the main guy.
Okay.
So is this a part of the train?
Yes.
Okay. Cool. I just couldn't tell. Okay, when I tell my wolf what to do, does that count as part of my turn, or does he have
no,
his own turn?
No, he gets his own turn.
Okay. So, I'm going to start shooting this guy, I suppose.
Yeah.
So... Oh, that's a crit!
Yeah.
Nice.
He could actually go down
and
here.
And that... Oh, that still passes.
Yes, it does. Yes.
8 dead
eye. Yeah.
So...
That still passes.
Okay. So that is, so that's 24 harm for the crit shot and 12 for the regular shot.
Right, see, your shots like rock into his chest, and he just like staggers backwards. And he goes, right, staggers back, and it's like hands his chest, and he's like, and just shakes, and then gets back up again.
He goes,
and he basically charges you, and okay,
so gonna stick Asher on him then.
Okay, yeah, you do that. It's fine.
So, does he get to attack twice then?
Yes.
Wait, what? What's his damage?
Oh yeah, we never did that. Oh shit, he's got a crit anyway.
Crit.
Rolls.
All right, so he passed both.
I would say 10, and it would be like 5 AP, so he would do 7 to this guy. So that's 14, 20. He's dead. Actually, yeah. The wolf like jumps on him, and it's like tears his throat out. It's like absolutely tears his throat out. And he just goes down like a gargling mess.
Yeah, so I guess I'll move him over here.
Yeah.
So, all the while I'm viewing this from a distance in my scope. Oh, God. There's one dog you do not want to piss off.
Yeah. So that was the leader of the entire band of brass killed by a dog. There you go. you guys, what do you want to do? What do you want to do?
Well, I guess... So are these guys doing anything?
Yeah, how are they reacting?
They're moving forward in the train, and they've taken up cover over here.
Okay. Can I have my dog get behind cover?
In your turn, you may. They're going to fire at you, though. They're not going to fire at the dog, they're just going to fire at you guys. And they will miss. One guy missed completely. They will hit Damien, they will miss Damien, and they will hit Shireen, and they will miss Shireen. So they do 4 harm to Damien and 4 harm to Shireen.
Okay.
But Shireen's automatically healed that this turn anyway, so doesn't really do any harm, so don't do it. Don't put it on. Because you healed 5 anyway. So okay, so you guys... Then. Turn, yeah, your turn. You can see them through the blown out side of the train.
I have a question.
Mm-hmm.
So this these guys were facing the Band of Brass. Is this like the entire group, or is this like a faction of their group?
This is probably the elite of their group. Well, not the elite, but you know what I mean. It's just him on his own little raiding party. But there'll be others out there, but not like.
Okay. Yeah.
They're not a substantial band. They're not like gonna, it's not like an army out there or anything.
Okay, can I get to the train?
Yeah.
That
would be your entire turn, though.
All right. Well, I just want to like talk, basically. You know, I want to.
You can do that. You can do that. I'll let you like run down. You're not trying to be secretive, so you can just run down to here, and like talk into the window if you want, keeping your head low. So just put your character down there.
All right. Come on. Can I move you? No, you're not gonna let me move here. Just do that.
Does stabilizing presence rotate me into?
It's fine.
No. He's pushing out his energy into other people.
Oh.
Okay.
So, what do you want to say?
All right, first I want to say to them, Damien, we want to keep at least one of these guys alive so you can get some information on your brother.
Yeah, I was planning the same thing.
Okay, well, I mean, I wasn't able to confer with you guys because I was way up on the ridge, so. And now I'm going to shout to the guys in there still. We've killed your leader. There is no reason to continue fighting. Give up now. Let us take what we came for, and you can walk away with your lives.
Okay, do a flash check, but minus 10.
Okay, give me 1 second.
Oh, okay, so it's 19. One of them, like, pokes his head up above the cover and says, you really killed him? And he looks over and sees the body of Backfire with his throat torn out, and he goes, oh, Backfire's had his last raid. fucking heartbreaking. And he goes back into the cupboard and goes there. And he confers with his mate, and they all go, all right, we're going, all right? Just, and they like, throw the weapons down. And goes,
kick your weapons over to us.
All right. And they, like, kick the weapons across the floor to you. Okay. And they like, stand up with their hands up.
All right.
There's about four of them now that are left. Yeah, it's four.
All right. I say let's subdue them and put them in one of the vehicles outside.
Okay. From the front of the train, a door opens, and because it's been locked away, locked off, you know, and six mm-hmm. clerks come out from the Nine Ways Rail Company, and they look over and they say, "Is it over? Is everything over?"
Not yet. Go back in the closet or whatever it is. We'll let you know when it's safe to come out.
He's like, okay. He's like a railway line administrator with like a big bushy mustache, and he's quite portly. He's like, of course. And he closes.
Don't worry, you guys are in safe hands. Don't worry.
He closes the door and locks it. So, do you guys want to put these guys in the truck over here somewhere?
Yes.
Yeah?
I do, at least.
Yeah.
Yeah? Okay, I'll put them over there.
Yeah, let's bind them.
Well, oh, yeah, are they, like, subdued somehow?
They're not subdued. You don't have anything to tie them up with, but...
Okay.
They're just in the back of the van there. They're just standing there. But you got them at gunpoint. They're not going to try anything.
Okay. Yeah. I think maybe, like... we can let Damien question them a little bit while Jackson and I search the train. And yeah, I'll leave Asher with Damien just in case.
All right.
And so, since those guys are still locked away, that gives us an opportunity to take the stuff without them noticing.
Okay, that's fine. One of them opens the door and peeks out and is like, she goes, "Psst," to you, to Jackson.
What?
Says, we owe you for our lives, for helping us out here, stranger. Look, how about we take your names, okay? So you'll have a decent reputation with our company, and we'll let you take a few crates from the cargo, and no one will be any the wiser, huh? And, like, taps his nose. If there's a reward, just a thank you.
Okay, I'm going to look to Shireen and say, what do you think?
Sounds a bit sketchy, but... Nah.
Well, that's a generous offer.
I mean...
I think that would be good to do.
Okay. He says, now that we're all on the same page, why didn't you tell me, do you have any crates in mind? Like any ones that you actually want, or?
Why don't we tell them that we'll look around? Like, we know what we're after, but they don't need to know that.
Yeah. We'll have a look around.
I need to put my stuff in the manifest saying that it got destroyed in the raid. So if you guys could just slip me a piece of paper with any of the crates that you take. Now, don't take any more than five, all right? Just, you know, any of the crates that you take, just slip me a bit of paper and I can at least go to them and tell them which ones got destroyed. So it doesn't look fishy.
Okay.
All right, so I'm going to go with the driver and make a cup of tea. You guys sort yourselves out. It's like switch the door.
Okay. Right, and I think, like, once we tell them that stuff, because we'll take five crates, I think. Mm-hmm. Whatever's in the other two is just for us. And, you know, we'll intimidate him before we leave. Like, you know, if you double-cross us, then, you know... We'll hunt you down. kind of thing.
Okay.
We'll do it.
So as you as you guys move through the train getting your different crates, we'll move out to Damien, and by the time he's finished, then you'll know. You'll be finished with what you need to do. And I'll tell you what's in the two bonus crates once we're done.
Okay.
Alright, so Damien, what do you want to do outside?
I'm going to interrogate them, ask them some questions about my brother and my hometown.
Okay. One of the guys called Shiv, he basically says, that wasn't part of the deal. You said you'd let us walk. I'm telling you fucking nothing. And sit back down again.
Alright, I'm gonna pull the stick of dynamite that I have on me. Out of my pocket.
You would.
Okay.
And be like, I've got a little friend here who's telling me otherwise.
And he goes, why don't you shove that up your ass and light it so we can all have a good laugh before we fuck off home?
Alright, I'm going to shoot that guy.
Okay. Yeah, he's dead.
Yeah. It's like, now, any of the rest of you want to start talking?
One of them goes, you killed Shiv number one. He had a lovely face. He just says, what do you want to know?
A couple of years back, your band attacked my hometown, and my brother, Aaron, was never found after the ransacking. What happened with him?
What town was this?
Brindale.
It was Brindale. And one of them pipes up from the back and goes, oi, isn't that the one where the mechanic kid came from? And he goes, oh, shut the fuck up! And he's like, oh, all right, he's being held in a place called Bricktown. It's about 15 miles north of here, all right? He's been treated well, or he has a job, he's all right. Just leave him alone. We gave him a life. Ish. Are you considering? Okay. Just so I know you're still there.
Yeah, no, I'm still here. I'm just trying to think of what to do in this situation.
What do you think Damien would do?
I look at them angrily, and I'm like, you gave him a life. You took his life away. You took him from everything that he knew. His family, you killed his family off, took him from his home. You call that giving somebody a life?
He just shrugs and goes, hey, he didn't end up on the corpse pile with the rest of the dung eaters. What, you know, what's the problem? He's alright.
The rest of those dung piles that you're talking about happened to be some of my family, all of my closest friends.
He just sort of goes quiet, but he's got like a smirk on his face as well.
All right. His arms. Yeah.
Do you want to do anything with a dynamite? Because, you know, there's no one.
Yeah.
He shoved up his ass. Light
I'm
it.
I'm going to.
Remember, it's long fuse dynamite.
Depends where he puts it.
Yeah, I'm gonna light it and like just hold it for a little while.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And be like, "How are you doing,
man? Mad?"
Okay, it's about halfway down now, that's what you're gonna do.
Yeah, I'm gonna throw it under the car
okay.
that they're in and dart.
Okay, no. I want you to roll Flash, but minus 40 for me.
Flash minus 40?
Yeah.
All right.
Okay. You take. After he smirks at you, and the rest of them start smirking at you as well. They're standing in the back of this van, this truck. You like get a cigarette out and just put it to your mouth and just like light it, and then you get like a long fused dynamite out and you light that as well, and you just sit there with it in your hand, and you look at them, and their smiles sort of fade, and you roll it underneath the truck, and you walk off slowly. Just toking on your cigarette as it explodes behind you, and only way a stuntman can, you refuse to run. You're like, no. If this engulfs me, I don't care. But this looks amazing. So you just like walk off and it explodes and behind you, and they're screaming as parts of them get ripped apart and flown all over the place.
Alrighty.
Sheree's nice. Pretty happy she's in the train right now, so she doesn't have to have body parts rained all over her.
Yeah, I guess I'm technically in the train too, huh?
Okay, so Sheree and Jackson, you have your 5 crates. You can't open them yet, so the driver gives you two keys to open them. And inside, let's get our goodies list up. Inside is a phase greatsword, a beam rifle, a ranger rifle, and there is a 2x armor piercing rounds, so you can use them for a thing. And there are 3 operative gears.
Okay.
And which one did you say it was? The phase greatsword or
phase,
just phase?
Phase greatsword.
I don't think you guys would mind if I grab that, would you?
No, go for it. I don't use swords.
Phase greatsword, armor-piercing rounds, a beam rifle, a ranger rifle, and three operative gears.
Yeah, operative gear is better than what we all have, so. Yeah. Just updating my things.
And what do we do with the gear we have now? Can we keep it and sell it?
You can stow it in the van. You can stow it in all the van, yeah.
Yeah. Keep it and sell it off later or something?
Mm-hmm.
Cool.
Yeah. I'm looking at the guns now. And
all right. So you guys have loaded up the van with your gear, and you give each other like questioning looks, you know, because of what transpired near the truck. And you guys, you hand the slip of paper to the driver, and he says, "We'll never forget what you did for us. Can you leave us like a stick of dynamite so we can clear the way to get out of here?"
Yeah.
Hey,
I say yes.
He says,
"Sure."
He says, thank you. We'll see you around. We'll make sure your names have carry some weight with the 9 ways. You know, if you ever need anything fenced or sold, you let us know. All right, we're in 9 ways town. It's about like 50 miles up the train line. Come see us there.
All right.
And you guys clamber in back into the van and pull away. And you're pulling away through like a vast expanse of orange as the sunlight goes down. And yeah, like the sunlight goes down and the temperature drops in the desert that you're in, and you're all sitting in the front of the van, you know, toking on a job well done. And you're driving back to Old Shackleton, and you hear like a screeching roar in the distance, and you can see in the distance a gargantuan dragon just flying over the peaks of the Hammer's Edge Mountains, which are just are well beyond Old Shackleton. And where its wings beat, the sun is like cut out, like, you know, the fading light of the sun is like beaten away, and then it comes back again as it goes away. And that's where we'll end the session for this first week of Driftwood.
Nice!
So, yeah.
Nice. Sweet.
All right, I took the beam rifle, by the way.
Yep, yeah, okay. Yeah.
I didn't even hear of everything that was there. Awesome. I was like, oh, sword.
Oh, yeah, you took the sword. I take the rifle. Timmy, do you want the other rifle, the ranger
rifle?
Yeah,
I'll take the ranger rifle.
As long as you guys know what's in there. And then there are two armor-piercing rounds. You can decide what you want to do at any point. You know, so it's up to you.
Okay, armor-piercing rounds for my sniper.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, go for it, because I don't really care. Oh. All right.
So I'll say goodbye to Twitch.
Jeez, guys.
Yeah, that was a good one. That was a good one. Yeah, we'll say goodbye to Twitch, and we'll speak to you guys later. I'm going to stay on. I'm not, like, going. I'm just saying goodbye to Twitch. So bye-bye, Twitch.
Bye, Twitch.
Bye, Twitch.
And YouTube.
And YouTube eventually.